Welcome back in this morning. Time to visit with our friends from the Imagination Station in downtown Toledo. And we're going to be talking about math in everyday life. Jeff Stevenson is with us this morning and has a technical definition of what we're going to be talking about.
Well, as you just said, we did have our 1 millionth visitor, which was super exciting. And so I decided to bring on a little bit of number science, I guess.
That was really cool. In about 5 years, right?
Yes.
A million people in the door of the Imagination Station. Of course, a wild success. And good to have people continue to walk through the doors.
We're shooting for the next million, so
don't worry. We do have a quick picture, too, of the family that was the 1 millionth visitor.
Yes, they were super excited. They had no idea, and they were just very ecstatic that they could be, and they got to go and be part of a show and got a big goodie bag.
How cool.
They had a great time.
All right. Well, I'll shoot to be number 2 million. All right.
All right. We'll hold it off for you.
So what are we talking about here?
I'm talking about, you may have heard of it either in school or in pop culture, is the Fibonacci sequence.
Okay. Heard of it.
I'll give you the first two numbers in the Fibonacci sequence. It's a 1 and a 1. All right. And how you get the next numbers is by adding the previous two.
Okay.
So what do you think the next number is?
2.
2, right? And then if I add the next two.
Just the next two?
Just
3.
Just the next two, we get 3. And then
5.
You can do 5.
8.
And it gets a little harder now, Chris.
Oh my gosh, 13?
13, yes.
And 21?
21, excellent. Uh-huh. So this is the Fibonacci sequence. You probably learned it at some point in like algebra 2 way back when, and you said it just enough to get through the test.
And then you forgot about it.
And then you forgot about it.
That's okay, though. That's why you're here.
And I've always heard that these numbers relate to spirals. I don't know if you've ever heard this before.
I have not heard this part.
I've always heard that these relate to spirals, and so I was kind of around the grocery store counting spirals on things that I found,
okay.
Right? So, and what I noticed is I have this pineapple here, and if you can see, it has two sets of spirals, one going down to the audience right.
Okay.
And then another set going down to the audience left.
Okay.
And this pineapple has 8 spirals going down to the left and 13 going down to the right. So
can I just take your word for it?
You can
take
my word.
I don't have to count.
Don't worry, I was there. I counted multiple pineapples. But this kind of happens all over. So I have an artichoke here, and it also has 5 going down one direction and then 8 going the other direction. So it's still a different part of our Fibonacci sequence, but still part of. And then you can find this everywhere. Like there's like horned fruit, and then the flowers you have next to you. If you look real closely, even the seeds at the tip of those flowers. Have spirals.
Like a similar structure?
Yes, they have a similar Fibonacci sequence of spirals that are going around the seeds. So, I don't know, check with sunflower seeds. A lot of plants seem to utilize this, even seashells. And I've always wondered why. Why is this happening?
You're going to explain this
to
me.
I'm going to try to.
Okay,
I'm
going
to try to. So if we can get like maybe a top-down view here.
Sure.
This is going to be my meristem of a plant.
Okay.
And the meristem is where all the leaves come off of. So let's imagine that one leaf came off my meristem.
Okay.
Okay. Now, where do you think the next leaf should grow?
Probably on the opposing side.
That makes a lot of sense, right? Because
yeah.
We want to maximize the amount of sunlight we're getting, right?
Okay.
So I'm going to want to put a leaf on the opposite side. And let's see if I can't. Yep, perfect. But here's the other question. If I did it 180 degrees, then the next leaf has got to be 180 degrees. And then what am I doing?
You're covering it up again.
I'm covering it up.
That probably doesn't make sense in nature, does it?
It doesn't make sense. So then the next thing is, well, what if I did 120 degrees? What if we did one here? Maybe you put one like a third of the way, Chris.
Okay.
And I'll put one over here. And then we run into the same problem again, though, right?
Right.
I'm then covering the next layer of leaves. So three-dimensionally, this kind of looks like, I have kind of a fake plant I can show you. Three-dimensionally, this kind of looks like this, where the previous leaves are covering the ones below it.
Okay.
And plants don't want to grow this way, right?
No.
Like, because then they're just like shading all of their own leaves. And so what the Fibonacci sequence gives us is the perfect angle to work with. And if you, it's a little complicated math.
Okay.
But if you take some ratios between these different Fibonacci numbers and you convert it to an angle, you get 137 and a half degrees.
Okay.
You might have to trust me on this.
I'm going to trust you on this once again.
But what I'm going to go ahead and do is we're going to measure out 137 and a half degrees from each leaf, and it'll kind of start to make sense. So if I put one leaf down, okay, and then I'm going to give you the next leaf to put down.
Measure out.
I'm going to measure out 137 and a half degrees. So put it down so at the very center of it's right
there. Gotcha, right on the line.
Right on the line.
Okay.
And then we'll do the next one here. All right, go ahead and put that one right there. And then it looks kind of uneven at this point,
right? It does.
But we're going to keep adding leaves.
Okay.
All right, and then I'll do it from that one. We'll kind of straighten it out a little
bit. Wait a minute here.
And notice how they're not overlapping over one another. Even though it seems kind of random, I'll give you another leaf, Chris. Here, take this whole pile of leaves.
Okay.
I made all kinds of leaves for you. We'll have the next one right over there. And it's filling that gap, like, just perfectly. And there is a small amount of overlappage, but
right.
The plant is trying to minimize the amount of overlapping.
So we couldn't do this before just by trying to randomly place them down, but...
Any even number wasn't going to work. You needed this kind of irrational number that the Fibonacci sequence is. And so, you know, even if we'll put one more down, and you can see that we have a very nicely even distributed. And if I kept doing this, if we did this with like 1,000 leaves, you'd end up getting a spiral. And if you counted the number of leaves in each one of those spirals, you'd get... the Fibonacci sequence.
Such as this there.
Exactly.
There we go. Makes sense now, Jeff.
I think that that's a really cool way to kind of incorporate math into science, and that we can talk about how plants, while they don't think and feel like we do, they are still using some of these laws of math.
And this is what you guys are doing at the Imagination Station. Anything big coming up too?
Well, we have tabletop science coming up at the end of this month, where we're learning all about kind of like, it's gonna be Thanksgiving with your family. What are some cool science tricks that you can learn and that you can kind of do at your table?
Very cool. All right, Jeff, thank you so much. Stay with us. We're coming right back in just a moment.